the other one is that, and you know, we say this wherever we go, that we've talked to people from Lanell and from Livermore and from there's probably a lot of guys from there in this audience. And we meet these guys, there you go, we meet these guys and they actually talk to us like peers, even though we don't have a science background, because they see that what we're doing is, the results might not be correct, but the methodology is science. It is, we're trying to tell a story, it's trying to tell a narrative about discovery, about understanding something, and building your understanding upon the evidence that of what you're learning. And that type of peers, that type of access that we're getting to talk to these guys is just incredible.
Yeah, it's a funny thing. It just, as it would happen, turns out to be that doing science is the most efficient way of getting an answer. We didn't train to do this. We just thought about it, and it's like, well, let's try this. Let's do it this way, and be methodical, and be careful, and it works. So that's what we do, and it actually helps, I think, in a lot of ways, especially for young people or people, average Joe in the audience, to understand stuff that they might tune out if it was presented in more of an applauding way, which is what you have to do if you're a real scientist.
You have to have a data set larger than one. Let's face it, no one's ever emailed us. Still, yeah. And thank us for the groundbreaking work and the really legend research we've been doing for many years. I think everyone realizes that the urban legends are just a fantastic scarecrow on which to hang an approach to science that's entertaining because it often involves people getting dismembered in really creative ways.